Hello everyone. Today we are going to start with the topic MS Word. So what is MS Word? MS Word is an application software, or you can say it is a word processor software, which is used to create documents, letters, like report files, and you can add images into those documents, you can add charts into those documents, you can add different shapes, different smart art images into those documents. So basically it is a word processor software which is used to create a document. Okay, it is made by the company Microsoft. So it is paid, fine. Its purpose is to allow users to type and save document. The extension of the word document can be .doc and .docx. What does it mean by the extension? That means type of the document. With the help of extension, we'll get to know which kind of the document is it. Like above versions of MS Word 2007, the extension of the documents will be .docx, and the below versions of MS Word 2007, the Word document extension will be .docx. Here you can see in the picture, when you open MS Word, what will be shown on the screen. These are the different different parts of the screen. What are the different names assigned to the different parts of the screen? Here we labeled all those things. Like here you can see here is written document 1 and Microsoft Word. What is this? This bar is known as the title bar. What is the document 1? Document 1 is the default name for the MS Word document. When you create, open any new document, the default name of the document would be document 1. Okay, and here this is the application name. Here it means to say the title bar will contain two things, the document name and the application name. Which application will be opened? That application name will be written over there. Fine. And this bar is known as the quick access toolbar. This toolbar is for adding those options which you are using frequently in MS Word. Like you can add those options here in the quick access toolbar so that you can easily access those options. This is known as the file tab, where you will, by clicking here, you will get options for save, save as, new file or open. Such kind of options are available in this tab. Fine. Here you can see these are the minimize, maximize and close options. Fine. After that, this is the help button. Okay, here so you need to click here if you want any kind of help. Built-in help, and this portion is this part is known as the ribbon. This part is known as the ribbon. Ribbon contains the different tools and the and some groups. Like here, you can see this is the clipboard group. This is the font group. This is the paragraph group. This is the editing group. This is the style group. So these are the different groups which are present there in the home tab. Here you can see this bar is known as the menu bar, and the single option of this bar is known as the tab. Here we are talking about the home tab. So in home tab, there are different groups are available, which is clipboard, font, paragraph, editing and styles group. Okay, in these groups there are number of options available which are known as tools. Like this is the bold tool, this is this is italic tool, and likewise. Fine. So if you wanted to launch a dialog box, okay, you wanted to open font dialog box, you can click here on this icon. This will launch dialog box on your screen. Fine. And this is your ruler. Okay, you can use ruler for adjust margins. Okay, that we will study in the later classes, how we can use this thing. Fine. Then here you can see these are the zoom control buttons. Okay, you can maximize the size of screen by clicking here, and you can minimize the size of screen by clicking here on this button. Okay, after that we have these buttons. These are the view button. Which kind of view you want for your document? Okay, you can control the views from here, from these buttons. After that, we have this lower bar, which is known as the status bar. This lower bar is known as the status bar, which contains like pages, how many pages are there in your document. It will show here, like number of words in that particular page will be shown here. Okay, such kind of options are here. Like after that, this place you can see on the screen is known as the document area, where you can see the cursor. Straight line is known as the cursor. Okay, when you type anything on the screen, cursor will be shown to you. Fine. I hope this is clear to everyone. Now we will start with how you can open or create a document. We'll start with this. Before starting this, we will see how you can open, like how to open MS Word. To open MS Word, you need to click on the like start button, which is the start button. You need to go to here. Oh, here on your screen. Okay, you will touch click on the start button. Okay, here in the recently or added program, if you have, you wanted to open your Word from here, you can directly click here and open the Word file. Otherwise, what you can do is the one Word file will be opened. Okay, you need to select here the blank document. A blank document will be opened there on your screen. What is the another option? Another option is you need to drag it down. Okay, you need to drag it down to the lower sections. After that, you need to select here from the Microsoft Office 13. You need to click on the arrow. After that, you will click on Microsoft Office Word, which is available here, the Word 2013. Okay, so that way your one document will be opened. Okay, what is the another way? Another way is quite simple way. You need to search here. You need to type here Word. And after that, you need to press enter. One file will be again opened your screen. Okay, this is for if you are using Windows 10. If you are using Windows 7, then what you will use? You will click on start button and simply search Word in that search box, and you will get a Word over there. Okay, and or you, what you can do is you can click on all programs, then Microsoft Office, then Microsoft Office Word. That way you can open Word. Okay, one another option is there, right click on your screen and click here on new, and after that Microsoft Word document, one Word document will be added on the desktop. Okay, you can see this is that particular document. So this way you can create your Word document. Fine. So first of all, we need to start with how to open or create a document. Okay, this we have learned, like how we can create a document. Like for creating, to begin with, let us create a simple document. Before creating the document, create a folder on desktop where you shall store all the documents that you create. Like you should always go with the creating a folder where you can like store your one type of data. Okay, and what we can do is, for example, here I have right clicked on the screen, I have clicked on the folder, I have written my docs, whatever the name you want, you can give to that particular folder. Here onwards, I am going to like save my files in that particular document. So for that, what I will do is we will start with the MS Word with creating one document. I have written here Word. Okay, when you will write here Word, one Word document will be opened on your screen. You need to select here blank document. Okay, then you can see a document will appear on your screen. First of all, you need to write something in the Word document. Like there is one predefined option available in the Word. What is that predefined option? If you will write is equal to R-A-N-D, that then two round brackets, let me increase the size of this text. Okay, after that, when you press is equal to R-A-N-D, two round brackets, starting bracket and closing bracket, after that, if you will press enter button, then it will provide you with some predefined paragraphs. These paragraphs are predefined by MS Word for the formatting purposes. Like in starting, when someone wanted to learn about the formatting, the person need not to write the stuff into MS Word. They can have the predefined paragraphs and can start learning the things. Fine. Now we have created the file. Now I wanted to save my file. To save my file, what I'll do is I'll click on file option. File option, I'll click on save. Okay, where I wanted to save this? Okay, I wanted to save this on desktop. I have clicked there on desktop. In desktop, which folder I wanted to save? In my doc folder. Okay, so I have double clicked on that. Here I wanted to give the name to my file. Okay, so I have given one name like a report. You can give any name to your file. Here, have given one name, that is report, and I have clicked on save. Now we can check on the desktop whether there is any document available on that screen. Let me enlarge the icons. Fine, here you can see this is my doc folder. Okay, when you click here, you can see there is one file named the report as saved over there. Okay, now I can see my file is present over there. Fine, so now we have already created one document. We have saved this document. And now I am again clicking on the like save as option. If you wanted to save the same file with a different name, then you will go for save as option. Like I wanted to save this file with a different name. So I'll click here on the save as option. I'll select my location and I'll give different name to my document. Likewise, I have given the name report one. Then I have clicked on save. You can see now the file name of my document as report one. Now let's see how many files are there in my docs folder. You can see there are two files, report and report one. Now if I wanted to open the report file, now what I can do is I can click on file, I can click on open. Okay, which file I wanted to open? I wanted to report file. I have clicked on that. You can see now report file has been opened. Fine. So that is it with the starting MS Word. That is what we need to learn. If you wanted to open a new document, you can click here on the new. Then which kind of document? There are some templates are also available. If you wanted to choose any of the given template, you can choose that. Otherwise, you need to click on blank document. It will add open one blank document onto your screen. I hope we are done with this. This is very introductory video to how MS Word, what are the different screen area, what are the different parts of the screen of the MS Word. Likewise, we have discussed this is customized quick access toolbar. Fine. And these are tabs. This is just the introductory video so that people who are very new to MS Word, they will get to know about the different parts of the MS Word screen. I hope this is clear to everyone. Thank you so much. Later on, we will discuss all these tabs with all these tools, with the explanation of all these tools in later on videos. Thank you so much.